parasitic protozoans. So parasite means it live on or within the body of other organisms for food, shelter or other requirements. And these groups actually cause harm to the host, and it is a one-way relationship where only the parasite is benefited. But still, majority of the parasites, though they infect host and causes harm, but it is not that level that it causes any lethal effects, because the survival of the host is somewhat related to the survival of the parasites also. So in your book, mainly two parasites are mentioned, parasitic protozoans are mentioned. One is Entamoeba histolytica, causing amoeboid dysentery, and the Plasmodium species, which are known to cause malaria. Coming to the Entamoeba histolytica. So these parasites are endoparasites, meaning they can live inside the body of the human or similar host, including many vertebrate hosts. And these organisms are grouped under rhizopoda, which is again a polyphyletic taxa, meaning it is not sure that it has originated from a common ancestor. It has multiple origin. Different groups have multiple origin. And generally, this parasite, why it is named as amoeba, because it has a pseudopodium like structure, but it is not that of to throughout the body. It is localized mainly in the only in the one side, the pseudopodium. Then the size could range from 15 to 25 micron, and majority of these parasites, the thing is that they can have different shapes, like in some stage, in the infective stage will be something, and the inactive stage, in that they will appear in some other form. So like that, it is very common to this. And majority of the this sporozoans and the micro sporadia phyla members are parasitic in nature. So here, mainly this, it inhabits the upper part of the large intestine in our case, and these are usually localized in the tropical countries are the one which is very close to the equator, and also in the temperate countries, however not that prevalent in the polar or that cold, very cold climate. So country like India, it's belonging to the tropical region, in one of the it is very serious problem affecting our place, and it causes the dysentery. Dysentery means, first the main symptom is loose motion, even blood in the stool, and it has some painful gastritis type feeling. So here, as I said, that it can form in different forms. The active motile form is known as the trophozoite form, and this is the form which actually resembles amoeba like, hence the name. And the trophozoite itself can exist in two forms again: the magna, which causes which is the major causative regions for ulcerative this thing in the intestine, and the minuta. In this form, it is more or less harmless only, and this magna is the one which actually can pierce the intestinal wall and inhabits the, causing this ulcers. And it can feed, it can feed on the red blood cells or whatever blood cells. And because of this nature, it can even cause blood thing in the, that is the reason why there some blood are also, because of the infection in the stool, we can identify the blood clots. And how it is doing the function is that it has several digestive enzymes, and these enzymes actually dissolving the our epithelial or the mucous membrane of the intestine, and this the blood are actually coming into contact with the intestinal content. While the minuter form also it's live in the intestinal mucosa only, however it is harmless and it never invades the tissue. And the body, if we compare, it is actually very thin, flexible, transparent, semi-permeable and all. And the cytoplasm could be clearly distinguished into ectoplasm and an inner endoplasm. And this endoplasm, again, if we check in this cell structure, there are many minute granule-like substances are formed, especially and this anterior end. So there is anterior and posterior end, though it is not that differentiated. So here the anterior end only the pseudopodia is formed, and this for this organism it is specifically known as the lobopodium. And these organisms, this lobopodium in some way it is helping in locomotion also. Again, it is in this inside this, as we can see the nucleus, if we say it is encrusted with a fine layer of the chromatin granules and other inclusions like food vacuoles, which is general in the other majority of the these groups, like even the plus this paramecium and all, you can see same way the food vacuoles are shown here. So this is the general structure. And as I said, beside the trophozoid, it can also exist in precystic and the cystic forms. And remember, it is the in the trophozoid, magna form is the one which is actually very dangerous. Coming to the reproduction and life cycle, for majority of the parasite, actually to complete its life cycle, it might require two hosts. For example, in case of this malaria causing, one host will be mosquito and the other host will be human. But in this case of amoeboid dysentery caused by the Entamoeba histolytica, it requires only one host to complete its life cycle. Hence, it is known as a monogenetic parasite. And it generally exhibit only a asexual mode of reproduction. And the major process is binary fission, and where the trophozoids are divided. And during the fission process, as generally it is like equally dividing into two, and from that four, like that it happens. And especially the magna form, which is actually the pathogenic one, the penetrates in the large intestine, and they grow by feeding the host tissue. So by host tissue they grow and feed, and these groups can even dwell the intestinal lumen, causing all those amoeboid dysentery symptoms. And in some severe cases, if untreated, this entamoeba can even invade the tissue and go to other organelles like liver, then even the lungs, brain and all. But definitely the majority of the cases we treat before that it goes to a serious condition. While the minuta form is a non-feeding form, and the cells contain prominent this thing in the large intestine. And these are the minuta forms are the one that actually get transferred again into a precystic forms and in preparation to form the cyst. So cyst, the advantage is that during the encystment stage, the precystic form will accumulate those glycogen and all the required the cell structure, whatever things are there, and they get produce a very resistant cystic wall around. And these are the cyst forms which is actually present in the feces, and these forms can survive in diverse different very rigid climatic conditions also. And when it enters the host, then again by the process of excystation, meaning the cyst wall is again getting digested, setting the metacyst free, and this thing again will cause and divide and multiply and forming a trophozoid. So generally, and this metacyst is free into the lumen, and this again can causes the in the cycle persist. And in the path, as I said, that in the pathogenicity, in the more severe cases, cellular necrosis. Necrosis is means where the tissues, you must have seen the necrotic tissue where it is almost like degrading type. Means, for example, in the the tissue will lose all the proper structure, and it will have that swelling, pus, and similar formation will start, which is the first step towards the apoptosis or cell death or programmed cell death. So here once again, so how it is getting transferred, we will check. Normally, as I said, when proper sanitation is not followed, if there is an accidental contact with the human feces, it can occur even through flies, cockroaches and all. And if the food is not properly cleaned and washed, this cyst could enter into our buccal cavity, to our digestive system. So digestive system, normally it enters, it is the main place is the large intestine. So here the cyst will get ingested. Though cyst itself cannot be, it's having no dangerous. The process by which once it is inside, that protective cell wall or the cyst layer is not at all required. So by this process of excitation, that cell wall is removed and it starts multiplying and forming the most dangerous form, the trophozoite. And again, by the simple binary fission, it can again form more and more trophozoites get released in the way. And some form, as I said, some forms will again prepare themselves to produce cyst. And same way, it is excreted through the feces and the cycle continues. So mainly the diagnostic stage and the infective stages are represented here. So it is possible to diagnose, and here what is shown is that if left untreated, it can even penetrate this the large intestine wall, and it can enter into different organelles like the liver, the lungs and the brain, which can even result in death of that individual. Coming to the prophylaxis, so as I said, it is transmitted through our feces. Sanitary disposal is highly recommended. Proper hand washing is required, because if you, especially the kids, will play with the soil and all, and in the soil we know that different organisms, their excreta is mixed up, because it is not only affecting the humans, actually it can affect many of the vertebrate hosts. So that their excreta also will release similar entamoeba cyst. And we need to protect the food from this house fly, cockroaches, etc. And always do a boiled water for drinking, and proper washing of the vegetables and fruits are highly recommended. And especially in some places, even for the agriculture, as an organic substitute, this human feces are used. But before using such feces or such things, it has to be treated chemically to avoid the cyst and all. And definitely health education and awareness is one of the things which can be also can adequate the importance of to others, the maintaining a proper hygienic practice. So here, as I said, that it is not the only genus species in Endomoeba histolytica. There are different groups are there, and according to their groups also, the cyst and the trophozoite forms are having some structural changes. And the most common, around 50% of Endomoeba belong to Endomoeba coli, which is actually is not a pathogen, because it can't invade the host. In fact, it is a common cell organism to us. And there is one other Endomoeba, only which is in the gingivitis and all, where the bleeding of gums, mouth and other, it means it mainly affect the our teeth sockets, and especially the gums become swollen, and sometimes it result even in bleeding. So this is another form. Then another other form is Entamoeba hartmanni is also there, which is also causing amoeboid dysentery. However, the severity in comparison to the histolytica, it is very less, not that fatal.